Hello everyone, and welcome to How-FixIT. In this step-by-step video guide, I'll show you how to install Windows 10 on your laptop or PC. If you need a different version of Windows, I've included links in the video description below. First, we need to create a bootable USB drive. You'll need a blank USB flash drive with at least 8 GB of storage. Insert your USB flash drive into your computer, and let's get started. There are two ways to make a bootable USB drive: using the media creation tool or an ISO image file. I'll demonstrate both methods. Click the link in the video description to visit the official Microsoft website and download the media creation tool for Windows 10. Locate the downloaded file and double-click it to open. Read through the license agreement, then click Accept to proceed. On the next screen, select Create Installation Media, USB flash drive or ISO file for another PC. Click Next. By default, the tool might select the recommended options for the PC you are currently using. If you need different settings, for example 32-bit or 64-bit, or a different language, uncheck. Use the recommended options for this PC and select your preferences. Click Next. You will be prompted to choose which media to use. Select USB flash drive. Click Next. Select the correct USB drive from the list. All files on this drive will be erased, so back them up beforehand. Then click Next. The tool will now download the necessary Windows 10 files and create the bootable USB. This may take some time, depending on your internet speed. Once completed, you'll see a message that your USB flash drive is ready. Click Finish to close the tool. Your USB drive is now ready to be used for installing Windows 10. Safely eject the USB flash drive or restart your computer if you are installing Windows on the same system. If Windows 10 is no longer available on the official Microsoft website, you can download the ISO file from archive.org, link provided in the description. This method will also work if you have an OEM version of Windows 10 that came with your laptop. Additionally, you will need software like Rufus, link in the description, to create a bootable USB drive. When Rufus starts, you will see a window with several options. Under Device, ensure your correct USB drive is selected from the drop-down menu. Click the Select button and browse to find your downloaded Windows 10 ISO file and select it. For most modern PCs with UEFI boot, choose GPT under the partition scheme. Under the target system, it should typically show UEFI, non-CSM if your system is modern. If you're installing on an older system with a legacy BIOS, you may choose MBR under the partition scheme. Rufus automatically selects NTFS or FAT32, depending on the ISO file size. Click Start to begin creating the bootable USB. Rufus may offer additional installation options to streamline the setup process. You can enable these options based on your preference. However, I will leave them unchecked to demonstrate the full installation process. A warning dialog will appear indicating that all data on the USB drive will be destroyed. Click OK to proceed. Rufus will copy all files and prepare the bootable USB drive. This may take several minutes. Once the process is complete, click Close and safely eject your USB drive to prevent file corruption. If you're installing Windows on the same computer, restart it now. When your computer powers on, immediately press the F12 to access the boot menu. In some BIOS versions, the key may be F8, F9, F10, Delete, or Escape. In the boot menu, select your USB drive to begin loading the Windows 10 setup files. If you cannot boot from the USB drive, enter your computer's BIOS settings and ensure Secure Boot is enabled and TPM, Trusted Platform Module, is turned on. Choose your language, time, and currency format and keyboard preferences on the first screen. Click Next. On the next screen, you'll see a big Install Now button. Click it. If you have a valid Windows 10 product key, enter it here. If you don't have it right now, or you plan to activate it later, or you're reinstalling Windows 10 on a device that was previously activated, click I don't have a product key. Activation will happen automatically once you're online. Choose the Windows 10 Home or Pro Edition that matches your product key. If your laptop's BIOS contain an embedded product key, it is most likely for the Windows 10 Home Single Language Edition. However, if you're unsure which Windows 10 edition to select, consult your laptop manufacturer's support for guidance. Click Next and accept the license terms if you agree. You'll be prompted for upgrade or custom installation. Upgrade tries to keep your files and applications if a Windows version is already installed. Custom is for a fresh installation. Select Custom if you want a clean install. You will see a list of drives and partitions. If you're installing on a newer blank drive, you might see unallocated space. Click New to create a new partition and specify the size in megabytes for the C drive. Click Apply to create the partition. Windows will create a new primary partition and one additional system partition. Any remaining unallocated space can be used to create a D drive by selecting New and applying all remaining space. This way, we have created two partitions, C and D. You can install Windows on one partition, C, and use the other, D, for storing data. I'll allocate the entire disk to the operating system by deleting all existing partitions. You can allocate partitions based on your preferences or install Windows on a single partition. Click Next once you've chosen or created the partition where Windows 10 will be installed. The installer will start copying files and installing features. This can take anywhere from a few minutes to an hour or more, depending on your hardware. Your computer may reboot several times. After installation, Windows 10 will guide you through an initial setup. First, choose the options you prefer from the region and keyboard layout. Select Setup for personal use and click Next. Sign in with a Microsoft account or create a local account. If you use a Microsoft account, you'll sign in with your Microsoft email and password. If you want a local account, look for offline account or limited experience, depending on the version of Windows 10. Follow the prompts to create or log in to your chosen account. You may see prompts about digital assistants like Cortana, speech recognition, or privacy settings. Adjust according to your preference. Windows will take a few moments to finalize your settings. Once complete, you'll see your Windows 10 desktop for the first time. After the desktop loads, it's highly recommended to run Windows Update to get the latest drivers and security patches. Also, check for any device-specific drivers, like graphics card or motherboard, from the manufacturer's website if needed. To check if your Windows is activated, open Settings, then open Update and Security, and Activation. If not activated, you can either input a valid product key, link, or troubleshoot your digital license with your Microsoft account, purchase a new license, or reach out to Microsoft support. Keeping your license details in a secure place and linking your license to a Microsoft account will make reactivation much smoother. And final tip, keep your system up to date, create a backup schedule, and ensure your drivers stay current. If you have any additional questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. Don't forget to check the video description for links to useful resources. Thank you for watching. You are on How Fix It, and I'll see you in the next video.